constitutional challenge against against the Big Shell jackpine operation. They want to massively expand it. And it was very, very moving because the chief there of that community spoke that evening at our event, and he said he had made an agreement with Shell in 1981 and then again in, or sorry, 2001 and then again in 2007. And he felt betrayed, very deeply betrayed by what had happened and what Shell broke their agreement. And he talked about flying over the territory and seeing what the damage that had been done, and said he felt that his heart had been ripped out of his body. And he talked about feeling so upset about what he'd done with these agreements that he had to go walking and drumming his sorrow away, is the language he used. He was so moving. And he's taken a very brave stand, because they're phoning him. They right up to that afternoon, they were phoning and saying, money, 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 how much money do you want? And, you know, almost like, how much personal money do you want? And it takes a lot of courage to stand up to that. And there weren't very many people from the community of Fort McMurray, I have to tell you, who came out to be supportive. So it was incredibly important that we were there as an organization to really give that kind of strength and courage. And so it was wonderful. And the next night then was Kamloops, and it was absolutely fabulous. We had a wonderful potluck dinner with the activists, and a huge crowd came out. And then last night we were in Burnaby, and it was, how many, 350 people maybe, in little Burnaby in a really cold gym. We were so cold by the end of the evening. It was just fabulous. And what I'm learning is that the people of British Columbia are so angry about how they're being treated. I mean, we're using the term that this is a carbon corridor, because there's not only the Gateway pipeline proposed, but there's a proposed extension, massive twinning of the Kinder Morgan, which would come south. But there's also, and we can't forget, the northern fracking. I mean, the biggest fracking operation in the world is taking place in northeastern British Columbia. And we had one of the young leaders, First Nations leader, who's just brilliant guy, Caleb Bain, was there last night, and he just put up a PowerPoint just showing what's happening in his area. There are camps of 1,000 men, lots of them around, just fracking, and there's no rule of law. I mean, it's just like wild up there. But what we're learning, and what has been so moving to me this week, is that the leadership for the resistance is coming from First Nations communities across this province, and I think also across the country. And I'm meeting, and I already know, but meeting more, a lot of a new generation of leader, both First Nations and non-First Nation, who are just not going to back down. And they're smart, and they know what they want, and they're very clear, and they're impatient when they need to be one, and then they're patient when they need to be the other. I'm feeling that we're really going to have to take that leadership from, to follow that leadership. Because the more I think about it, the more I realize that what the Harper government is doing is removing the tools that we have, all these environmental tools that we've had up until now, the environmental assessment process, and you know them all. And they're starving the municipalities, and they pulled these provinces into free trade agreements that bind their hands. And so what level of government do we have left that has real resistance? First Nations. I mean, they do have treaty rights. And so I'm feeling that the work that we did, for instance, supporting First Nations on getting the United Nations Declaration on the Rights of Indigenous Peoples, the work that we did and the leadership we showed on getting the human right to water and sanitation, these are going to come to the fore now. These are going to be very important for us in this fight. So I feel, we're up against the Harper agenda. We all know it, and that's what we're doing here this weekend. We all know they got a majority. We all know they don't care about us. They don't care about the environment. They don't care about democracy. We know all that. But we also know that we can build resistance, and we can take on certain campaigns, and we can win. And this pipeline fight, we can win. I am absolutely convinced. There are 50 municipalities and 132 First Nations who've said, no, you're not coming through my land. Wow. Yeah. Unbelievable, wow. Right? And the polls are very clear in this province. People don't want those pipelines. So if we can get the heart of Stephen Harper's agenda is to make Canada a superpower. And the way he wants to do that is to make it an energy superpower, and also minerals. It's minerals, fish, forest, and next water, I'm quite convinced. And that's the agenda. And he's on one hand stripping all these environmental rules and tools, and on the other signing these new trade agreements, dangerous new trade agreements, that give foreign corporations brand new rights in our territory, like our collective territory. I'm using the territory word I've been hanging out with First Nations all week. So it's, I think we need to see what he's doing, and we need to go to the heart of it. And to me, the heart of it are these trade agreements like CETA, like this new FIPA with China, and I'll tell you more about that, you know, in tonight's talk. That's really, there's a huge movement building, and we were in the Globe and Mail today being blamed for, you know, having thousands and thousands of emails and letters and calls to the Conservative MPs over this because of So we need to go to the fights that we can win, and one of them is this pipeline fight. And I think it's really important that we, and luck in a way, because it was the time of BC to have its turn here, but that we're in British Columbia when this fight is heating up. And it's wonderful to have Bill McGibbon, our good friend, here. He just gave a wonderful statement to the media. He was wonderful last night, and he'll be wonderful tonight. It's going to be a really smashing weekend. We have our job cut out for us. I mean, this is the worst government we've ever had in this country, and I say that in a nonpartisan way, truly. I mean, I would be, we would be collectively this angry at any government that did this, but we are building a resistance. I feel a whole lot more hopeful than I did last year. If any of you remember my little down speech last year, was like, it's really going to be bad. It is bad. It's all the things we predicted, but we are building a resistance, and I feel that we're going to win some. We're obviously losing some, but we're going to build a movement that will take our democracy back. So I really deeply appreciate everything every one of you does. I mean, I say this and I mean it with all my heart. There's nothing I could do without you guys, without the activists, without our members, without our chapters. It's just the work could not get done. There's no way any one person or any one group of people could make this happen. So I thank you so much, and we're just going to have the best weekend ever. And look at the nice thing that they gave me. The city of Nanaimo became a blue community, and the artist gave me this beautiful thing just now. Yeah. A new symbol. We're looking to have, you know how the in Quebec they had the red square, the red felt square? Well, here in British Columbia, this is the new symbol of resistance. It's a water drop.
Oh, yeah.
And so it's to protect the water, but it's also a reflection of the pipeline fight. So I think we should probably get some blue felt and have a little cutout party. Not jammy, but we'll have a jammy party. I'll come in my jammies and we'll all cut out. We should get some felt today, and we should all be wearing these by tonight or tomorrow. So
you gotta work for the Great Lakes.
I know.
Too,
I know. So. I think it absolutely. Yeah. And you do know that we're sold out. We had to turn people away. I mean, we're hot.
We're hot.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Maude.
Thank you, guys.